कैन यू जस्ट टेल मी व्हाट यू नो अबाउट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस?
ए रोबोट विच कैन एबल टू थिंक.
ओके दैट्स फाइन, ए रोबोट विच कैन एबल टू थिंक, या व्हाट एल्स?
मशीन विच कैन परफॉर्म एक्टिविटीज और टास्क लाइक ह्यूमन बीइंग्स.
ओके या दैट्स फाइन, एंड व्हाट एल्स?
फेस
फेस
रिकॉग्निशन,
रिकॉग्निशन.
ओके दैट्स फाइन, या व्हाट एवर यू सेड दैट्स ओके, बट आई
विच कैन
आस्क
लर्न बाय इटसेल्फ सर.
या लर्न इटसेल्फ, राइट? दिस अमेजिंग थिंग, लर्निंग इज द इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. फॉर एग्जांपल, we can do mathematical calculations like addition, division, multiplication, such things, and a calculator also can do, right? Calculator also can do addition, division, multiplication, all these things. Then can you call that like intelligent system, calculator? Yeah.
No,
Reason.
sir.
No, sir.
Reason.
Intelligence only, but not artificial intelligence.
Well, that's not intelligent system. Why?
Because somebody has to be operated, sir, that one. It don't has own intelligence.
What intelligence? Intelligence means is it like learning capability?
Yes.
That's related to learning capability, right? Suppose if you try to compare yourself with a calculator, who can compute faster?
Calculator only.
Division, addition, multiplication, such things. Yeah, in general, who can compute faster?
Calculators.
Calculator,
Yes,
right?
sir.
Based on this, can you say that is more intelligent than you?
No, sir.
No, sir.
What is the reason? That's fine. That's not intelligent than you. That's for sure.
Because it has to be operated by someone, no, sir.
Okay, it has to be operated by someone. And one more thing, it can't learn new things. That's pre-programmed, right? That addition, multiplication, division operation. You might study this in digital electronic circuits course. There'll be some logics, right? Using that binary format. It's pre-programmed kind of thing. That'll blindly follow that program. It won't adapt the program, right? According to situation. That program remains same. That's not adaptable in nature. That's why you can't say that is more intelligent than It's blindly following some algorithm. Some deterministic algorithm, which is not adaptable to scenario. Okay, that's fine. Regarding face recognition or voice recognition, do you think humans are better or your personal computer is better?
Humans are
Personal
better.
computer, sir.
Who will be better? Humans are personal computer.
Humans, sir, of course.
Humans, right? Yeah, can you just give me some examples for that? Where you came to know this? Yeah, that one.
Sir, it is because it should for a image processing or something else, we have to provide the heavy neural network. Heavy neural network, which consists more than very different varieties of people's images. And even though each and every data should be imported each and every time, sir.
Yeah, I will tell one thing. Or can you just tell me applications where you are using that one? Like face recognition and voice recognition kind of thing.
Phone pattern, sir.
Okay, phone
Mobile
pattern,
pattern. Yes, sir.
mobile pattern,
Face recognition.
face recognition. Okay,
Yes.
do you think that face recognition is accurate enough?
No, sir. Sometimes it won't recognize.
It won't recognize, right? For example, you wear a hat or you are wearing a mask. Mask,
yes.
Now that due to COVID you are wearing mask, right?
Yes, sir.
Actually, yeah, this year proven 3 months back itself. In US, face recognition system is there. Face recognition system. That's able to perform very well, at least 98% accuracy. After COVID, what happened is everyone is wearing mask, right? The mask is mandatory, the face mask. After wearing face mask, that performance is just 30% accurate, 20 to 30% accurate. It's not more than that one. But as a human, can you recognize?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, we can.
Can you recognize your parent or your friend when they are wearing a mask, face mask?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You can recognize very easily. Yeah. You can adapt so easily, right? For visual task, that's very easy for you. But when coming to that addition, multiplication, division, these kind of operations, calculator is performing much better than you, much faster. But when coming to visual task, this is good. Can you just tell me the reason why this is good compared to that computer? Which one is stochastic? Stochastic or probabilistic? That addition, multiplication, division operations, is it stochastic? Stochastic means there is some variability or some probabilistic in nature. Is it probabilistic? Or face image is probabilistic. Probabilistic means there should be some random variations in that particular face. Consider some person X. That person X face, that won't be identical always, right? Day by day that will change. Even hairstyle might be different sometimes. Sometimes he or she might wear hat. Sometimes there might be glasses, right? Sunglasses. There are so many things, right? And some makeup is variable, right? This face recognition task is including some sort of probabilistic thing, right? It's not deterministic. But when coming to that division, addition, multiplication, these operations, it's a deterministic algorithm. Deterministic algorithm can give the output, right? That won't change, right? 2 plus 3 equals to 5 always. And you are giving always input as 2 or 3. 2 plus 3 output is always 5. That won't affect, right? But when coming to this visual task, that person face might vary slightly due to some other reasons, hairstyle or something else, a beard. Some people might have beard after a few days. It's a randomness, right? That means whenever there is some randomness, you can say human's learning capacity is much better compared to that computers. Whenever there is some randomness is there. Whenever that is deterministic in nature, you can simply have some deterministic algorithm which can compute that one. That can be done with the computer much faster compared to you. But when coming to this stochastic task, you can perform much better compared to computer. Yeah, can you just tell me any other stochastic task or probabilistic task other than vision?
Speech,
right? Speech also stochastic. For example, different people will speak differently, right? Same word. Suppose you want to speak number one. The number one can be spoken by different people with a different pitch or different variations, right? The patterns. Still, we are able to recognize that one. Suppose if you are speaking number one, and some other person is speaking number one, we can decode it like one only, right? Without any doubt. Even though that pattern is different, that exact pattern might be different, whatever you are receiving. Not only that one, across same person also that can vary, right? Suppose you can speak number one fastly and you can speak the number one word bit slowly. That means within the same person also we can find that variability or stochasticity, right, in the pattern. That speech pattern can be different even for the same word. That can be different across people or for the same person also. Still you are able to recognize it. Still you are able to decode that one properly without any doubt. That's the greatness of human beings. For a computer, it's very hard task. That's not so easy. It can't decode it very easily. That speech recognition, that's not so good for computer as compared to human beings. Yeah, what is? Okay, that's fine. For example, you want to describe your friend. You want to describe about that physical qualities of your friend. How to describe? See, some unknown person came to you and he asked you like, can you just describe me about your friend, that physical features, how to explain?
Using height and color.
Okay. Height, that's fine. Color and what else?
Clothes.
Okay. Yeah, that's, yeah, forget about that. Yeah, what else?
Fat, thin.
Okay, and what else? Yeah, let's make it more complicated. You might be seeing this in movies, right? For example, yeah, if a person saw the crime, he is nearby that crime scene, and some people try to sketch the things very easily, right? Specialist people. If you try to explain regarding the features of that person, you will try to sketch that person's face. In that scenario, how to describe?
Expressions.
No. You want to describe
eyes.
Yeah.
Eyes, nose, lips.
Yeah, can you just tell me how to describe briefly?
Any marks on the face?
Okay, marks on the face and what else?
Curly hair.
Comparing with the object.
Okay, hairstyle. Yeah, what else?
Long nose.
Okay, and what else?
Structure, like a face is like a circle and so.
Yes, that's fine. Yeah, what else?
Color of the beard. Eyes.
Oh, color of the eyes. Yeah, what else?
More beard.
Okay, more beard. That's fine. Yeah, what? Yeah. Okay, eyebrows. Eyebrows means?
Like.
Is it like distance between eyebrows? Is it like that? Length of eyebrows?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, what else?
And size of the eyes?
Yeah, that's fine. Size, dimensions, right?
Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
And if he's a good person, if that person can sketch whatever you are describing, they may get approximately same picture. The person who is dictating should be good enough. And the person who is drawing that picture also should exactly follow your instructions. Then approximately you can get that person picture without any doubt. If you are able to describe well with such features. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, now I'll ask you a question. Forget about this description. Let's go back to the face of a person. Let's go to that picture once. Let's consider this person's face. Oh, is it visible, right? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's fine. Consider this person's face. It's the face of a person, right? Do you know about this one? Pixels concept. What is the meaning of pixel? Yeah, I will ask. A bit clear way. What is the meaning of 256 by 256 email? What is the meaning of that? 256 by 256? Or you might say like 1024 by 1024 image size, 512 by 512 image size, something like that, right?
Length and width of a picture, sir.
Okay, length and width of a picture. That corresponds to samples as well. Along this X coordinate, for example, if I say 512 by 512 image, the meaning of that one is you'll have 512 discrete points along this line, X coordinate, and 512 discrete points along this line. Then total, how many points you'll have in this? How many discrete points? 512 cross 512. 512 means 2 power 9, right? It means 2 power 9 into 2 power 9. 2 power 18, total number of samples in this particular image will be 2 power 18. That many samples you are storing in a digital memory. Okay, suppose you want to store grayscale image. How to store that one? I've heard about grayscale image or color image.
Yes, sir.
See, grayscale image means, one example is this one. That picture will be something like black and white, that's it. Like black and white face. Color image means that looks like natural. It's a combination of red, green and blue, RGB combination. See, with the combination of red color, green color and blue color, you can frame, you can design any color, right? It's a mixing of RGB, red, green and blue. The difference between grayscale image and color image is each and every pixel in the grayscale image can be represented by single value. Each and every pixel. If you consider 256 by 256 image, there are 2 power 18 pixels or 2 power 18 samples. And each and every sample or each and every pixel will be represented by single value if that is grayscale. If that is color image, you will write a friend with three values. One value corresponds to red component, another value corresponds to green component, and another value corresponds to blue component. Now I'll ask a question. For example, for a black and white image, you required 10 KB memory for storing that black and white image. And in order to store color image of same size, how much memory you require? Forget about compression.
More than 10 KB.
No. Can you just forget about compression? You are just storing pixels as it is.
30 KB, sir.
30, right? Because for each and every pixel, you need to store red component, green component, and blue component. Here you can store only one component, if that is black and white picture. Here you need to store, black and white means only intensity. Intensity component you will store. If that is color image, you will try to store red component, green component and blue component for each and every pixel. It means three times, right? Three times that thing. If that is 10 KB, this should be 30 KB, right? Into three. Okay, that's fine. Each and every pixel can be called as a sample in this one. Indirectly, this is a sample. If this is 256 by 256 image, how many values you need to store? For example, if this is the person who committed that crime, and you want to store this 256 by 256 image in your brain, then how many samples, how many values you need to store in your memory?
256 into 256.
Two days.
Yes, sir.
2 days into 3. These many values you need to store in your brain. These many values. Instead of that one, if you describe this person, how many values he required to store? Instead of storing each and every pixel in your brain, you are trying to store that patterns, whatever the description you said, you are trying to store that description in your brain instead of storing pixel wise. Then how many you require? How many values you need to store?
256 into 256.
No, forget about pixels. For storing each and every pixel, you need to store 2 days into 2 days into 3 in your brain. For storing this one, pixel wise. Instead of storing pixels, you want to store that description. One of you answered me, right, earlier. Like how to describe a person. Like someone said like eyes color. Someone said like distance between the two eyebrows. And someone said like shape of the face, right? Round or square shape like this one. And someone said like whether beard is there or not like this. Yeah. With these kind of descriptions, how many you require? How many values you require? Roughly, no need to tell me exactly.
I think it's a value, sir, I think.
Yeah, how many?
Very less amount of data is required.
20 to 30 maximum.
20 to 30. Yeah, that's more than enough, right? You can simply go for 20 to 30 features. That's more than enough. These are called like a features. F-E-A-T-U-R-E-S, features. You are trying to describe that person's face with the help of roughly 20 to 30 features. Like distance between eyebrows, that size of eyes, color of eyes, that skin tone, like this, right? In that way you want to describe. Can you call it like a compression? Is compression indirectly? See, yes. Instead of storing each and every pixel,
yes, sir, compression. That
means, yeah, this is compression, right? Instead of storing 3 × 2^18 values in your brain, you are simply storing 20 to 30 values. It's highly compressed, right? You are doing a lot of compression. For that, what you are doing is you are trying to extract some features. In this case, features means that color of eyes or skin tone or distance between eyebrows or the shape of that face like this or hairstyle. The other features like that you can think. That means, yeah, one more question I'll try to ask. Which one is more responsible for identification of this person's face? Is it edges of this one or color of this person or which one?
Eyes.
No, if you want to recognize this person's edges. Face.
Edges, sir.
Edges, sir.
Edges, right? That means if someone gave you that sketch, sketch means they will try to draw the edges of this person, roughly, that edges. You know what is sketch, right?
Rough pattern, sir.
Sketch means they will try to draw only that boundaries. Like eyes boundaries, They'll try to draw with the pencil. That's it, with a pencil. That sketch is more than enough, right? To recognize a person. If the person who is drawing that picture is good enough, that sketch is more than enough for the recognition purpose. It means that you are trying to recognize some person or someone with the help of boundaries, right? Is it true?
Yes, sir.
With the help of edges or boundaries, such things, right? Instead of blindly storing each and every pixel, what you are doing by default is you are trying to store that pattern. You will never try to remember each and every pixel value. As a human being, you will try to remember the patterns. And from the patterns, you will try to extract that face. That's what you are going to do. That's a general thing. You won't blindly store everything in the memory. You'll try to apply some logics to get back to that face. That means by default, you are doing some sort of compression. Okay, suppose if your mother or your father called you from some unknown number, unknown mobile number, can you recognize their voices?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You can recognize easily, right? Even they are calling you from some unknown number. Yeah, how you are able to recognize?
Voice, sir.
Voice, right? Some pattern, right?
Yes.
By default, some pattern is there. See, even though they are speaking something different, some other words. See, suppose in front of you, they spoke something, and in your mobile phone, they spoke something else, some different words. Still, you can recognize the pattern, that voice pattern, right? Can you recognize or not?
Yes, sir.
You can recognize very easily, right? What you are starting there? No need to tell like, I am your father or I am your mother, like that, right? Still, you can able to extract something. What is that something?
Voice pattern.
They'll try to follow always some pattern, right? Some voice pitch. They'll have certain pitch. After that, they'll have something inside, some extra thing. Some features. You might be feeling like some of the features are common to this voice and that one. That's why you are able to recognize. You are trying to recognize some pattern in their voice. That's what you are doing. The pattern recognition is everywhere. But for a computer, that's very difficult task. That can't recognize so easily. That voice recognition, that person identification is not so easy for a computer. But for you, that's very easy task. Yeah, can one of you explain how learning will happen to a kid? Just consider 1 year kid, newborn kid. What they will learn and how they will learn?
He listens from his surroundings and then.
Okay, they'll try to listen from the surroundings. After that, they'll try to imitate, right? Is it like that?
Yes, sir.
They'll try to imitate the same words. That's what they'll do. And what else? Listening. In addition to listening, what else?
And what they see.
Yeah. They'll try to observe the things, right? They'll try to see. They have vision, right? They help our vision. They'll try to see the world and they'll try to record. They'll try to react accordingly, right? Okay, that's what they'll learn. It's a learning process. I'll ask a question. What are the major difference between human beings and animals?
Human beings are rational. They're able to think and they're able to choose what is good for them. Whereas animals, they can't.
Okay, animals, they can't. Okay, that's fine. It's a good thing. Humans can learn or they can adapt easily as compared to animals. That's for sure. And I'll give one example. But some animals have special properties by what they'll have that one. For example, if you consider zebras, they can run within one day.
Yes, sir.
After their birth, they can run within one day itself. They can run like anything. How that's possible? But as a human, how many years you require for running? After your birth?
5 to 6, 7 years.
Okay, roughly, yeah, for running at least, may require 3 to 4 years minimum. Okay. For zebras, they can run in one day itself after their birth. Can you guess what is the reason?
Because it's in its genes, sir.
It's in genes. Okay, that's carry forwarding, right? Yeah, what else?
Balancing it's capacity.
Instinct behavior.
Okay, balancing capacity. And what else? Okay, which one is more responsible if you want to do something? Brain is responsible. Suppose you want to walk. You want to walk or you want to run. Do you think most responsible thing was legs or brain? Which one is more responsible?
Brain.
Brain and legs.
Why? Why? Without brain, you can run or you can walk. Is it true?
No, sir. It's false.
That's not true, right? You require the help of brain for any activity. For any activity, you require the help of brain. For example, just consider paralysis. What is the meaning of paralysis? Paralysis to some hand. For example, right hand.
It can't work, sir. It can't.
It is unable what to signal, sir, from brain.
Yeah, this one way. Right? One way of paralysis. Yeah.
Then also that hand has gone wrong.
Yes. For example, let's assume like there is a blood circulation to that right hand. That means you are having enough food, right, for that hand movement or anything. But if some fault is there in your brain, generally motor cortex will be there. Motor cortex in the brain, which is responsible for any movements in the body. If that's not giving the signal to your hand, you can't move your hand. See, you can think. For example, like, I want to move my hand. That you can think in your brain. But unless your motor cortex gives command to your right hand, it won't move that one. The thinking part is different from this one. I should give instructions, right? The motor cortex should give instructions. Without that, you can't move your hand. Without brain, you can't do anything. Brain is like a processor in your computer. You both are same, right? Can you map brain to processor? Is it same or different?
Same, sir.
It's almost, yeah. In some manner, they are fine, right? For your computer, the processor will do all those computations or whatever you want. For human beings, the brain will take care of everything, right? These computations. The brain is like a processor. You can think of like that. What are the sensors here? Sensors means they'll try to collect the data from the world or from the environment. What are the senses?
Eyes
for human beings.
Ears.
Eyes. Ears.
Ears. Nose.
Nose.
Skin.
Okay, tongue. Skin. And tongue.
Tongue, sir.
Okay, these are the major five senses, right? These are the five senses. These senses will try to collect the data from the world. They are just collecting. Who is processing the data?
Brain, sir.
Brain, right?
Brain.
Brain should process the data. After processing, these sensors will collect the data and brain will try to process that data. After processing, it will try to acquire some knowledge, right? You see, like earlier I gave some example, right? Our brain will not remember each and every pixel in that image. They will try to remember that pattern, like dimension of eyes, nose, ears, like this. The features only that will remember. After that, they will try to re-extract that one, that original picture. That's what your brain will do. That means your brain will try to reprint that data in the compact manner somehow, using some processing. That will do some processing. That will try to reprint in a compact manner. That's what your brain is doing. Okay, that's fine. If you want to replace this human being with a robot, how to replace? Can you just tell me? What are the components that you required?
Camera.
Oh, camera. In place of what?
Eyes.
Eyes, sir.
In place of eyes, right? Yeah, in place of eyes, you require camera. What else?
Processor instead of brains.
Okay, processor inside of brain. Whatever the data collected by camera, that should be processed by that processor. Yeah, what else?
Mic. Sensors.
In the place of ears, recorders.
Okay, in the place of ears, what do you require?
Microphone.
Microphone. Okay. Yeah, I will tell one thing. If you want to imitate that person exactly, do you require any constraint over microphone? What is the audible range of your ears? Audible frequency band?
20 Hz to 20 kilohertz.
20 Hz to 20 kilohertz, right? What is the range of microphone? Will it allow only 20 to 20 kilohertz or will it allow beyond that as microphone? The microphone will allow anything by default. That air pressure variations, that air fluctuations, that can be about 20 kilohertz also, that will allow. You may require some filter, right? You may require filter after that. See, yes, we can't hear the sounds of bats. Bats. You know bat, right? What is bat? Bats means?
It's a mammal, sir. Mammal.
Yeah. You can't hear, right? They will try to hear the sounds about 20 kilohertz, ultrasonic sounds. You can't hear that one. If you want to exactly imitate that one, you may require filters after that one. You may require some filter after that microphone. Okay, that's fine. And what else you require? Okay, these are the two major things. That's fine. Generally, they'll try to use these two things. And one more thing, for example, consider a robot. Do you think that can walk in the night time also, in darkness also? Is it possible? I want to create a robot which can walk without any trouble, without light also. Is it possible?
So if you use radars, they can, sir. Without radars, we can't.
Okay, if you are using radars, that's possible. One way is you can go for radars. And another way is you can go for IR cameras, right? infrared cameras. Instead of capturing visible light, you can try to capture that heat from the objects. Infrared cameras. One way is infrared cameras, another way is radars or lidars. Such things you can do. Without light also, they can sense the objects. Okay, that's fine. It means if you want to imitate a human being, majorly required sensors, right? Which will try to capture the data from the real world. For example, cameras or that microphone you required, followed by you may require some memory and you may require processor, right? You require processor to compute all these things. And what else you require? Yeah, what is the major difference between calculator and human being? I'm repeating the same question as well. Right? What is the major difference?
Calculator is already it's a pre-programmed one.
Pre-programmed or deterministic, right? And what about human? Humans, that's not pre-programmed, right? They'll try to learn new things. Human will try to learn new things and adapt. It means you require some algorithm which can learn from the experience, right? If you want to design something similar to human being, there should be some algorithm, there should be some machine learning algorithm, or there should be some pattern recognition algorithm which will try to learn from the experience. From the experience means, what is the meaning of experience here? Just consider human beings. What is experience? What is the meaning of experience from world? What is the meaning?
From past data, previous result.
Okay, that's fine. From the past data, the previous result. For example, eyes might be collecting data from the book, for example, some test book. You'll have to read that content and you'll try to summarize that in the brain, right? Some data you are collecting. And that ears can collect some sound, for example, some lecture that can collect some data, that audio sound, and after that your brain can try to represent that data in a compact manner. Like that you can do, right? Experience means first you need to face some new things. Your eyes will try to collect some new data, or your ears will try to collect some new data, or if that is a human being, that skin can collect some new data from the world. How skin can collect new data from the world? Can you give me any example?
Whether it is cool or hot, winter, yes. Rainy season.
Yeah, the cool or hot or winter, rainy, such things. These are the new things you can collect from the world. And after that, your brain will try to represent that entire data compactly. Okay, that's fine. Do you think your brain will try to process that eyes data, that ears data, the skin data, all the things separately? Or it will try to coordinate all those things?
Try to coordinate,
coordinates.
You try to coordinate, right? Otherwise, you can't get the things properly. For example, as you said, winter season. Winter season means you can find some fog kind of thing, right? And you can feel some coldness. You require eyes. And you require that skin, right? Skin sensor also for this. And you require so many things, right? In general, brain will try to coordinate all those things. They might be processed separately. Eyes data will be processed separately. That sound data will be processed separately. Skin data will be processed separately. But at the end, there will be some centralized system somewhere to try to coordinate all those things, this collective information. That's what your brain will do. And it will try to update its knowledge from this experience. Experience means you are collecting new data or you are going for new observations with the help of all these five sensors, and these observations will be processed by your brain, and it will try to take it like an experience. It will try to gain some knowledge from this experience. That's what your brain is doing. In a similar manner, if you are designing a robot which can imitate human being, that should have this quality of learning. That's the important thing. That should not blindly follow your instructions. That should try to learn. It means there should be some learning algorithm which can try to update its knowledge from the experience. Experience means whichever the data collected by eyes, ears. Eyes, ears means in this case from the camera, or data collected from the microphone. This new data is there, right? Based on this new data, that should try to update itself. That should try to update the knowledge like human beings. Yeah. That is the thing we are going to learn in pattern recognition course. You should try to extract the patterns, useful patterns, and you need to recognize such patterns. From your experience, you will try to get some abstract knowledge from your experience, abstract knowledge, that overview or summary of that entire thing. And with the help of summary, if something new came, you will try to decode that with the help of this past experience. That's what your learning algorithm will take care of. Yeah, any other doubts? See, I am expecting more interaction from you for this particular course, because my main intention is that should be helpful for your placements. In E4SIM1, you are having placements, right? Now the trending one is machine learning or artificial intelligence is a trending one. If you try to ask more things, I'll try to explain even beyond this syllabus also. That's what I am expecting from you. Yeah, if you have some discussion, you can start. No problem for me.
Sir, what are the major difference between artificial intelligence, deep learning and machine learning?
See, the main difference between these three things is artificial intelligence means, as you said, like they should try to learn the things just like human beings, right? That's what someone said. Yeah, that's almost same as that one. Machine learning or deep learning, these are some of the learning algorithms which will help to get AI. They are just part of AI, artificial intelligence. They are just some learning algorithms. Machine learning, you will find some learning algorithms. In deep learning, you will find some other learning algorithms which will try to learn the things from the experience. Artificial intelligence is that abstract manner. That's overall thing. Yeah, what else?
Sir, can you explain machine learning by practical example?
Okay.
I didn't understand, sir.
Okay, machine learning with practical example. I'll go in another way. Oh, have you seen this one? Oh, what are you seeing in this picture?
Advertisements.
Advertisement, right? Targeted advertisement. Targeted. What is the meaning of targeted advertisement?
It reaches only particular audience.
It reaches only particular audience, right? How that's happening?
It's based on our history, browsing history.
Based on your browsing history, right? For example, if you search something in your Google, like bicycle, if you search for bicycle, maybe after one day or on the same day itself, you might get some notification from Amazon or Flipkart regarding bicycle ads. Can you see such things?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how this is happening? Do you think someone is sitting somewhere and they are simply watching you, what you are browsing, and they are giving ad, or what's happening? Who is doing that one? Do you think machine is doing, or a person is doing, or some employee is doing?
Machine is doing.
How that machine is able to do that one?
Maybe there are some instructions so that when we search a particular for thing, then okay.
Yeah, that's also fine. It means it may not be complete learning, right? According to your analysis, that may not be complete learning, but some fixed set of instructions can be given, like from this IP address you got this one and you are projecting this ad to you. That's fine. And I'll ask one more thing. Suppose if you search a movie in YouTube, along with that movie, you'll get some suggestions. Have you seen that one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, along with that particular movie, you can have some more suggestions, like these movies you might like that. Yeah, how that's happening? Let's assume you are a new user. You are a fresh user to YouTube. And you log in with your Gmail. After that, you browse that one.
With a keyword, sir.
Yeah, with a keyword, you search some movie and you got that movie. But along with that movie, you got some recommendations. These videos you might like that.
That is related to other persons who search the same, sir.
Is it exactly the same thing or something different?
Similar thing, sir. Similar movies.
You get similar movies, right?
Same category example, movies.
Yeah. For example, some people will try to watch comedy movies only. Some people try to watch horror movies like this, right? Some people may watch the combination also. See, for example, if I'm searching in Basel some movie, that can't blindly suggest me the movies from other countries, right? Will it suggest?
No, sir.
It won't suggest blindly, right? That will follow some strategy. What is the strategy?
It also considers locations.
It will try to consider that location, that region, particular region, and what else?
And language,
and what else?
Age,
yeah. What else?
Genre.
Nearby people searching.
Yeah, people searching with your mentality. See, the people who are searching with your mentality. For example, you can try to group people in different categories. There will be some set of 100 categories, for example. The first category people might watch some sort of movies. Second set of people might watch some other movies like that, based on their mindset. Their mentality. There should be some clustering, right? Or there should be some grouping based on your mindset. But how you are a first time user to YouTube, but you log in with your Gmail, then how that knows your mindset? Definitely that will suggest which are the movies which are favorable to you. Definitely that will suggest good movies only according to your mindset. How that's possible?
Based on Gmail data.
Gmail data means what you can expect?
Like country.
Only Gmail or from Google also?
Like country. And taking the history from the whatever browsing.
Yeah, by default that will be linked everywhere, right? Suppose if you browse that Gmail somewhere in Vijayawada, for example, or Hyderabad. And during that time, you might browse in Google or somewhere else, right? Some data. this can gather the data, right? You can gather everything, whatever the data you are browsing. That will try to imitate your mindset, or that will try to frame a model for your mindset. That's what that internet is doing. That will try to design your mindset, a model for your mindset. And some other people are with approximately your same mindset. They will try to group into single category. Based on this, that will try to suggest the movies. People with similar mentality, they can watch same movies, right, roughly. That's what the thing they are suggesting. Can you call it like machine learning? Or is it blindly following some deterministic strategy? The machine learning one, right? That's trying to learning. That's doing lot. That's trying to summarize so many things, right? That's trying to summarize your mindset. What kind of interest you are having, that everything gathering, and that's trying to group the people with the similar mentality. That almost try to show the same ads or show that videos, suggest that videos to that entire group, roughly same videos. See, for example, there are 1,000 people in that particular group with the same mentality. And you are a new user, but that knows that you are falling in that particular group. Other people are browsing the videos regularly, right? Based on their browsing history also, they can suggest you the movies, not only your history, based on others, that 999 people in the particular group. Based on their collective history also, they will try to suggest a movie to you. That's why they are successful. See, if they are blindly showing some random suggestions to you, you'll try to quit from that, right? You won't go to YouTube if they are suggesting you very bad things. They should try to suggest the things which are relevant to you. That means so many efforts done by the background, right? The machine learning algorithm. Yeah, what is, any other doubts? Yeah, that is 1 hour, right? Yeah, that's fine. Thank you. You can have tomorrow class once again. We have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday from 11 to 12, right? In the timetable. Okay. Thank you.